and welcome to Money Motivation. I am somewhere by the seashore and you can almost hear the water, you know, hitting the shores, and it's refreshing and it's energizing. Well, we're continuing our series on growth mindset, and today I want to talk about stretching the limits. I seated by the shore this morning and it seemed like the water was way into, you know, you'd walk a distance before you get into the deep waters. And I've been sitting here about 3 hours, and the interesting thing is that eventually the water begins to fill up across the shore, and right now you can hardly stand at the shore. Now it would be so easy for me to get a perspective of the morning and say, well, this ocean is actually not deep at all, because in the morning people are walking, you know, a couple of meters into the waters, and then come back in the evening and another person would sit and be like, hey, no, you can't actually walk into this sea. That's the same thing about us and potential. So talk about the growth mindset is the fact that we all have limits. But the question is, who sets the limit? Who defines the limit? Are we setting our own limits, or are we being defined by other people's limits? And it kind of works both ways. You can sometimes limit yourself to what you know, to what you can do, to what feels comfortable, to what is familiar. And yet other times we are limited by what people think of us, by what people have said, because people have defined you a certain way. You kind of limit yourself to that definition. You've been told you're just an IT person, so you limit yourself to IT. You've been told you're just a mechanic, and you limit yourself to being a mechanic. But at the end of the day, the thing about your growth ability is that you can set your own limits. You can define your own limits. You can stretch the limits as far as you want, and there's no boundary line apart from the ones you draw. Interesting thing is that more often times what we perceive to be limits, what we perceive to be our boundary lines, are imaginary. It's all in your head. You have told yourself, I cannot do this thing. And because you've told yourself you can't do this thing over and over, indeed you fail to do it. I have come across people who say, I can't drive. Now you'd think that anyone can drive as long as they took the lessons. But because you've told yourself, I cannot, that is one of the most defeating statements we tell ourselves. When you say, I cannot, you have disenabled your brain, you have disenabled your system to even try, to engage, to explore, to just be in the space where you can try. So before you say you can't, step back and ask yourself, have I tried it? What's the worst that can happen if I try? So stretch your limits. There is more to your life. Go beyond your normal. Go beyond your familiar. Go beyond your comfort zone and tell yourselves, if I can imagine it, I can do it. If you can dream it, if you can envision it, then you can do it. So how big is your dream? How big is your vision? What are those things that you've told yourself, I can do it? Sometimes some of the most amazing ideas just don't make sense the first time we hear them. But hey, when it becomes a reality, we all step back and we are like, you know, the person said it and they did it. So stretch your limits. Dream big, as far as your eyes can see, as far as your mind can go. That's as far as you can achieve. That's as far as you can accomplish in life. Because at the end of the day, we are masters. We can stretch, we can grow, and we can stretch our limits like the ocean. There's no limitation. You can be at one point today, but tomorrow you could be at another point, and you can decide the pace at which you're moving and how far you want to go. How people perceive you is their perception. How you perceive yourself is your responsibility. My name is Noeline Chirabo. Have a blessed day and a blessed week. Let's keep the conversations going online. Catch you next time.